Hey there, it's Rich, Roman Rich, out here in Arizona. I'm on a reunion tour. It's been a long time since I've been out here and done some videos. So last time I was here and did a video, I shot the Apache Death Cave. Yeah, that's what they call it, the Apache Death Cave. And Old Man Miller, the guy that ran this place, Two Guns, he promoted the heck out of this death cave, and you'd pay a toll to go down in there. Now, it used to be, prior to today's deterioration and everything, you used to be able to cross over a little wooden plank bridge down over here and then walk down through a pathway through this little canyon underneath an archway, I believe, to get to the cave. But you don't have to do that anymore. See that little canyon down there? I used to walk underneath where I'm standing. This was like a little bridge. And then right down there, below that wooden bridge, that's the cave. That's the Apache Death Cave. So, I'm a little bit older. I don't know that I'm any smarter. Probably not any better looking than I was 10 years ago. I'm probably a little bit bigger than I was 10 years ago. But last time I went and I had a gun, I had a little gun. This time I got a big gun. Just in case there's any surprises down there that I don't want to encounter, such as a vandal with a spray can, might not like him too much, or lions, tigers, zebras. Anything I don't want to come encounter with, I got a gun. So that's my prerogative. I'm not saying that's what you got to do, but that's my prerogative. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going my own way on that one. So what do you say we make our way into the Apache Death Cave? I've also got more lights this time. I've got a headlamp. I've got lights on my camera. And then behind me, in case you have noticed, I got a light sticking out of my behind so I can light up everything, so that nothing is dark, hopefully. And if one of my lights fail, I've got a backup. Now, I was hoping to have somebody with me when I went down in here, but I don't. But I did notify my lovely bride back at home that if she didn't hear from me in an hour, that she better call help. So hopefully this isn't one of the last videos I record. All right, let's make our way down. Gotta watch out. There's a telephone pole through here, and I like to walk on the telephone pole, but not those wooden slats. I don't trust those wooden slats. I'm 200 some odd pounds, and I'd step on one of those things and break, and I'll break a leg or something else. So this old entrance has been sealed off by rocks that have fallen right ahead of us. And that is kind of the big worry about going into this place, is rocks falling. Let's see here, turn our light on. There, I got on the lowest setting. And I'm gonna turn this light on, so that we can see behind us. Bump that up a little bit. That should be good. Well, last time I went in here, I didn't get very far. To be honest, I got a little spooked. The light I had wasn't great. And you can still see that video on YouTube. Go check it out. You'll see how much younger and handsome I was back 10 years ago. I got a little spooked, I'll be honest. And I just didn't have a lot of confidence in that light. Today, I got more confidence, and I think we'll be okay. Let's see what we find. This is a dry cave. Most of the caves
I see back at home are wet caves. Already we see evidence of vandalism by some immature, inconsiderate people who don't have anything better to do. So it's a little tight through here. My light and back is hitting things. Already I'm having issues. There we go. Get a little crawl space here. Alright. So we can see up at everything. You can see we're probably about 30 to 40 feet below the surface. But what worries me is all these rocks you see falling all over the place. At one point, they built a retaining wall here. I don't know if that was to serve as a room or to prop something up, but they did a dry stack retaining wall. There's a little crevice there where you can get inside. I'm not going to do it. I'm too big for that. There's another crevice over here that you can kind of go down into. Again, you can see up there's a big giant boulder looming overhead. It's pretty spooky. But people have been going in there. I see footprints. It looks like it gets really, really tight about 30 feet into that crevice. It's just not casting good enough. Yeah, there. It's blurry, but yeah, it goes in there. A little person, smaller than me, can get in there. I'm 6'4", almost 6'4". I shrank a little bit. But here is where that other room is. You can see, not that big of a room, but it's something. All right, we'll continue on. Watching overhead. The giant boulders that loom above us probably squash me like a grape. Here we have another dry stack foundation of sorts. This rock here in front of us has fallen. It's a big giant rock. And again, more vandalism, although at least they took the time to make it look like it was old and Native American. That one doesn't bother me so bad. When people that spray paint things, they're just the scum of the earth. Getting darker. This is a big room. Lots of foot traffic here, obviously. I see, you can kind of see some of the formations here. You know, this is all dug out, but you got this crevice that looms overhead. More dry stack wall there. Small crawl space in there. I don't know that it goes much further than that, and that's too small for me to get into. But again, the disappointing thing is we see ridiculous amounts of graffiti, and that was not here 10 years ago. So we have a problem with society today that is evolving, or should I say devolving, where people feel like they have to resort to this kind of senselessness. Very disappointing. Okay. Notice this time, though, compared to my last video, I don't have my gun drawn. I'm not as scared as I was last time. Okay, moving forward into the next room. see the crevices. Turn the light up a little brighter. No graffiti in here yet. Oh, no, I'm wrong. There's some right next to me. Someone had to put a star there. Good for them. Maybe they didn't get enough stars in kindergarten, so they had to make their own star. What's this up ahead? I see something hanging from the ceiling. Disturb him. I only see one, but he's just hanging out there sleeping. We're gonna let him go. Not gonna bother him. Okay, now we get to a point that I haven't been to before, and it's looking pretty tight. Say right now we're 50 to 60 feet at least below ground, maybe more. It's just about as far as I can see. I don't even know if I can squeeze in here. I got too much stuff on. I'm too fat. Wow. I'm not that big of a person, but I'm having a hard time squeezing through here. Through here, I see the footprints. Maybe I should go on a diet. Yeah, I see more rocks looming above. I'd say we're easily 60 feet underground. Easily. Looks like it gets narrower. I don't know how much further I can go. In there, but I can't make it in there. That's too tight. Go further. Yeah, I can't. There's one, there's a little corridor through there. There's no way. I'm a pretty skinny dude, but there's no way. I can't. There's less than 12 inches of clearance there. I'm lucky if I can even turn around at this point. Gosh, okay. And that's exactly what I'm going to do, is I'm going to turn around. Because that's as far as I can go. Maybe somebody else has a better video, because I can't do it. No way. I gotta lose weight if I'm gonna do that. Wow. Gosh. Okay. Well, I wish I knew what was back there. But, you can do anything you want in life, but you can't do it all. And I'm too big for that. It's opening up now. I'm feeling a little better. I do get claustrophobic. There's a little crevice in there. Doesn't really go anywhere. All right. A little tight again. So, if I haven't mentioned it already, if you like this video, be sure to hit the like button and subscribe to my channel, because I do lots of cool stuff up in that Route 66, like trying not to get stuck in a cave, and which I just almost did. Okay, and then, yeah, more than anything, though, I like it when people share my videos. That encourages me more than anything to make more videos. Our little buddy the bat out there again. Can't see him. I don't want to bother him. Got a hard enough time dealing with all the people coming through here and vandalizing the place. It looks like maybe. Yeah, I thought maybe it was a shell. It's not, just some sediment. It's neat to look at the walls of a cave. You can see the different levels over time that have occurred, you know, through erosion and different sediment deposits. It's cool. Geology's kind of neat. Got a little debris down here. Okay. Gosh, I keep hitting that light behind me. Wow, that headlight makes a big difference. So, what do you think so far? Pretty good? Probably going to be my last visit to the Apache Death Cave for a long time. I hope somebody out there will get the courage built up to do something with two guns, something productive and something that contributes to the community of Arizona and Route 66, because this is a real gem. This is, people come from all over the world to see two guns. And this is just one of the cool things you see here. I feel a breeze. I can hear the wind. But I don't see any daylight. Okay. Interesting, this piece of rebar that's here. Not sure what that's for. It's a big piece of rebar, though. Huh. Yeah. Okay. Well, that's about it for the Death Cave. Gonna mosey on out of here, hopefully, safely. So, if you decide to come to Two Guns, bring a friend. That would be much smarter and safer than what I just did. Yeah, now we can see some daylight. Look at that above us. It's the outside world. What a neat place. How cool would it have been to come here in the late 40s, 50s and meet that old man Miller and tour the cave and
see the mountain lions and just, I mean, this is just like raw Arizona. I mean, this is just the coolest thing ever, man. And I feel blessed to be able to see it today. You know, I wish it was, you know, a little bit more preserved. But I can let my imagination fill in the blanks, I suppose. All right, let's go. Let's get out. At one point, it's been so long since I've been here, I thought I was going to bring my one wheel down here and one wheel through the cave. Obviously, that didn't happen. Alright. Oh, there's another crevice up in there. Where'd that go? Maybe we can climb up there and see where that goes. Have fallen down and caved it in, which I don't want to be a victim of the next cave. So, okay, we're gonna get back down. Okay. All right. Yep. There's the outside world. I'm almost free. That was cool, wasn't it? Light still on. That was cool. Alright. That's two guns. How about you guys, again, hit the like button, subscribe. More than anything, share that video. I love it when people share. And, you know, something else I don't really talk about too often is leave your comments. I'm out of breath for some reason. Yeah, leave your comments. I try to interact with every single comment I see on Facebook and YouTube. I don't always get them all, but I do my best. Sometimes it takes me a little while to get to them. Keep in mind that I do have a family with 5 kids, and they're all young, and right, at least at the time of viewing, they're all young right now. But, yeah, leave your comments. If you have questions, I'll try to answer them and do the best I can. I'm not perfect, but I try to be helpful. Okay. Go watch some more of my videos, please. See you guys later. I'm Roman Rich. This is the Apache Death Cave. Go your own way. You'll be glad you did.
It's Rich, Roman Rich again. Not too thrilled about crossing this path here. Hopefully my wife doesn't get the cash in on her life insurance policy. I'm not liking this at all. Yeah, all these boards are loose. That's about a booby trap if I ever saw one.
I always carry a gun with me wherever I go.